Live from the Alamo City with Bridget Smith, featuring Eileen Tevis, Paul Morellis, and Natalie Tejeda. This is Great Day SA, San Antonio's number one lifestyle show.
And good morning.
Hey, good morning. How are you doing this morning?
You just get a hug.
Good morning.
Good Friday morning. How's everybody doing? You know, I'll tell you what, Chuck, it is always great when you come on the show.
It is always great to be on this show. This is my fantasy. When I was a little kid, I wanted to do the TV thing, and now I'm doing it.
Yeah.
Thank the good Lord above.
And I tell you what, you do a great job at it as well.
I appreciate that. Thank you very much.
And Chuck does so much. You know, he's like the man about town. He does Spurs, he does SeaWorld, he does a whole bunch of cool stuff, and we're going to talk about all that fun stuff that Chuck's a part of in just a few minutes.
That's right.
We have so much good stuff going on. It's a Friday morning.
Thank God it's the end of the week. Thank God it's
Friday. Woohoo!
Yes. Have y'all been to the Valero yet?
I have not.
If you're going out to the Valero today, weather's going to be fantastic for it. The golfers are going to just love it out there today. So.
And you cooked that up, right?
I cooked that up.
Good job, man.
Especially just for the Valero.
Yeah. What a guy.
Hey, guess what? We've got some airheads with us today.
Yes, we do.
No.
We've got, it's the American Lung Association. Yep. They're in the audience today. Thank you so much for being out here. Very spirited. And they've got a cool event happening this weekend. We're going to talk about that and a little bit later on in the show. But first, we have to wish a big happy birthday. Can we get some music for this lovely lady? Happy birthday, our own Eileen Tevis.
Oh, look at her.
Look at her.
She got little pigtails on the side.
21 years ago today.
Wow.
21 years again.
Wow, look at that picture. Did you see
that's
that first
fantastic
picture?
And she's taken the day off today to celebrate her birthday.
Yes.
So happy birthday. Continue
success and blessings.
She's
probably getting to, you know, hang out, sleep in a little bit this morning and, you know, do something with her sweetie. Now, but look at that adorable little picture.
Now, have y'all ever seen Monsters, Inc.? She looks just like the little girl that was in Monsters,
the
Inc.
The little girl. With the footy pajamas.
So, yeah, so cute.
Yeah.
You know, and you know, she doesn't look a day over 21 these days, so I would say happy 21st birthday again, Eileen.
God bless you, Eileen. We love you.
And Chuck, you know, speaking of cool people that we just love hanging out with, you are just doing so much. You're the SeaWorld guy, you're the Spurs guy, but you've got a bunch of cool stuff going on with SeaWorld right now.
Yeah, SeaWorld is in our 25th season, and I have been there for 25 years next month. I'm so excited about that. Yes.
No way.
Great company.
You must have started, Chuck, when you were five.
Had a great career with the beluga whales and dolphins. I'm now spending a lot of time with the sea lion crew out there and helping out with that team. The company has just offered me so many opportunities. I get to do some national spokespeople. I appear on the Live with Kelly and Michael show.
Wow.
And it's great. And, you know,
were you really on that show?
Four times.
Wow.
We bring animals. And we want to just teach people about the great animals that we have and all the great things that SeaWorld does. And thanks.
One of my favorite shows out there, and I can't remember what we call it now, but it's with all the diving and the...
It used to be called Viva, but now it's called Azul.
Are you still in that show?
I am not in that show, but I'm good friends with all those people. I was over there when that show was created and with the beautiful beluga whales and the Pacific white-sided dolphins. Just a fantastic show out there. But another fantastic show is that sea lion show. I don't know if you've seen it.
I love
the sea lions. It's hilarious. That's my new team. That's my new crew.
Okay.
So go out and say hello to the sea lion crew.
You know, what's really cool is whenever you go to SeaWorld, they have a special office where all the media people go, and you all converge there, and they make you wait at a table, and you wait to be escorted in and around the park. And I walked in there one day, and I see in this really cool picture frame a picture of Chuck, and he's like the media like welcome wagon, a picture of Chuck with it, and he's posed with a dolphin.
I'm
like, and there he is, a big smile. And that's what I always remember when I go to SeaWorld. I remember Chuck and a big smile, and it's like, yeah.
But what you need to do is you need to remember all the great family fun that we have out there.
Yeah.
You know, this month is Kids Month. It's just for kids. Every weekend there is a different act. I think we've got Kalu's coming up, Lori Berkner, Choo Choo Soul, Imagination Movers.
Oh.
Every Saturday, something for the kids out there. And of course, we have Aquatica out there.
Aquatica's getting ready to reopen again for the season.
And I tell you,
we've
made some upgrades in Aquatica, including a swim up bar.
Oh,
I'm just saying.
That's a good addition. Now, you're a busy guy because you got Spurs going on, too.
Yeah, talk about Spurs. We had a tough game last night. We don't want to talk about that too much.
It was a little tough, but we'll get into that a little bit later. But yeah, I'm very
look at you. There you are in action.
Yeah.
I love going to the games and seeing you in action. Anytime, the when you'll see Chuck is whenever there's like
the timeouts and the halftime.
I'm the
in-arena host, and my job is to go out there host the promotions, play some fun games with the crowd, and just amp up the crowd. And,
yeah.
You know,
and if they're not excited before, they get excited when you come out there.
Oh, well, thanks. Yeah, it's so fun. It really is a Spurs family. I mean, between SeaWorld and Spurs and an occasional acting job here or there.
You're all over the place.
I'm having a good time.
Well, thanks for being with us today.
Thanks for having me. This is a treat.
And I like the little pin, too. I like that.
Yes, this is the Spurs, the official 2013 Spurs Fiesta. Wow. We got that. Got
that
right
there.
What is the chance, Chuck, that I can get one of those?
Perhaps if you
ask and you shall receive. Here we go, right here. Hey, speaking of receiving, somebody's going to get some passes to go see the Huge Groove on this weekend.
We've got some VIP passes for Huge Groove. And now this is going to be, these passes are for the VIP lounge. There we go. Complimentary food and beverage. Beverages. It's going to be on the balcony above the streetscape at La Cantera. So this is cool. But you got to get the quiz prize.
Oh, there's a quiz question.
Yes.
And I think it's a fairly simple one.
I have no idea what the answer is.
Go ahead.
So what does sushi literally mean? Is it A, raw fish, B, small delicacy, or C, sour tasting?
Just give us a call at 946-GDSA, 946-4372.
All right, you can go out there.
I think I have an idea now that you've given me the multiple choices right there.
See, that's what we do. We give the multiple choice. That way, you got a fighting chance.
Right. And one of them's kind of ridiculous always.
So you got a 50-50 shot. Yeah. Exactly.
Okay, speaking of multiple choices, when you go to Vegas, right, there's choices. You can go get married in the little Chapel of Love. You can go, when I was running the Las Vegas Rock and Roll Marathon, you could stop on the course and get married. Here is a new thing for you to get married in Vegas, because a lot of people like to go and elope to Vegas and get married. Now, after a night of clubbing, you can go get breakfast at Denny's and get hitched in the Denny's Chapel.
Because that's always a good idea.
So Denny's, it's not good enough to have all this.
The Grand Slam and the Rudy Tooty Fresh and Fruity. You can now go get married and get breakfast at the same time.
So I can just see that. I can just see that. The chef comes from around the kitchen.
And marries
And he becomes, the minister.
Uh-huh. And then the reception is probably
pancakes.
Right there.
Yeah.
Pancakes are always good at 3 o'clock in the morning.
There you go.
And that Denny's in Vegas probably has some champagne, I would imagine, somewhere.
Something like that. A full bar, perhaps. Can you imagine reception party of 30, your table is now ready?
Now, here's the question. Are you legally married if you get married at Denny's? I guess so, right?
Well, the way it works in Vegas is you still have to go and actually get your marriage license. But any chapel or place where they perform a marriage is legally binding.
That is interesting. Now, who would do that?
I think it's only like a $30 fee. When I was reading the article, I'm
30
like,
bucks?
But I'm thinking, if you can have your reception and your service and everything all in one spot, you don't have to really worry about transportation. You don't have to worry about catering. It's all in one spot.
Right.
Okay. I think it's an interesting idea. I don't know if it's
for me, some folks will take advantage of it, I'm sure. All right. And also, we got some lot going on this weekend. We got a couple of races. We got the Airheads going on. And by the way, it's not me. I said, are you sure you want me to call them the Airheads? And they said yes.
They wanted to be called the Airheads over there. That's right.
But also got Race for the Cure.
Huge Race for the Cure. I used to be on the Komen board a few years ago. I was in the Susan G. Komen San Antonio affiliates board. But this year is the Race for the Cure this weekend. About 30 to 40,000 walkers, runners, 5K, 10K, even people who want to sleep in for the cure, survivors and runners, walkers, people of all different, anybody who wants to participate, they can. This tomorrow morning. Now, if you haven't registered yet, you can register day of, you can register online, you can register today at the Alamo Dome. Registration, depending on what you want to do, is between $30 and $50. So it's a chance for everybody to get out and be a part of. And again, a majority, over half, I think like 60-70% of the proceeds stay here in San Antonio.
Now, the Race for the Cure is down at the Alamo Dome.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
And then the Airhead Walk is at SeaWorld.
My place!
That's
Come
right.
on!
That's
so,
right.
So, Chuck, which one are you going to?
I'm good. I'll be at both of them somehow, some way.
That's right. See, I'll split in two, and I'll go do Race for the... I'll do the 10K at Race for the Cure. Now, I'm so fast, I'll run over to SeaWorld and then finish up the Airhead Walk.
So you're going to do 20Ks tomorrow.
That's
I like
right.
to see that. Okay.
Right.
All right. Great. Okay. Gina's on the line with us. Gina, are you there?
Yes.
Okay. Hey, how are you doing today?
I'm doing great. I love you guys.
We like you too, Gina.
We love you too. I'm going to go give you a big hug. She's like, no,
Happy
too
Friday.
Close,
yeah, yeah. Hold back.
Right. Okay. What does sushi, what does that literally mean?
It means sea. sour tasty.
Yes, you are right.
See, that's the one I wouldn't have got.
That. I thought that was the one that we just threw in for fun. Right. I thought it meant raw fish.
No. Right. And sushi doesn't taste sour. But anyway, Gina, you're going to go out and have a good time out at the La Cantera.
That's right. You get to go, and we have these VIP passes for you. So enjoy that so very much. And the reason we brought this up is because coming up, it's date night. And what's better than a little bit of sushi and some sake? But did you know that it can be tough to actually pair the two? We've got the expert coming up, and he can make you the expert for pairing that sushi and sake for the perfect date.
And also, it's Student Aid Saturday, and we've got the 411 that you don't want to miss. That's coming up.
And you saw our beautiful Spurs medals. How can you get the Spurs medals? And we'll talk all things Spur with my buddy Andrew Monaco. It's here from the AT&T Center.
It's a wonderful Friday and great day. And
right,
don't go anywhere.
Friday.
We're talking Go Spurs, Go Fiesta, and
Cheers.
Sake.
Stay with us. Cheers.
So let's go somewhere no one else can see you and me.
Hey, welcome back. Okay, just like with wine, there is an art to pairing sake and sushi.
Yes, and to give us a crash course, that is, in matching, is General Manager of Piranha Killer Sushi, Kevin McCauley, is here.
Good morning to you.
Thank you. Hi, Kevin. Thanks for having me.
Good to see you on a Friday, and it's perfect date night discussion right now. I'm looking at all the great sushi. I'm looking at, is all this sake?
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, we were talking a little bit beforehand. Tell us what sake is. I've always heard that it's wine made out of rice, but there's more to it.
It's a rice wine. It's actually brewed like beer. It's used with mulled rice, water, and yeast. Of course. Go ahead.
I always thought there was just one type. Whenever sake. I've gone to like a restaurant, they've said, do you want sake? And you go, yes. They bring you out one type. I didn't realize, is there like a red, a Merlot, a sparkling? Or...
Right, exactly. Just like people use different types of wood to age different types of wine. We use different types of yeast to make different flavors of sake. And then also it depends on how well you mill or polish the rice down. The more you polish, the less proteins and less fat there is to the sake. You get to the pure starch in the middle, and therefore you get premium sake or some of the lower end.
Now, Kevin, we're talking about all this sake, and it's sitting there right in front of me.
Yeah,
I know it's 9 o'clock here, but it's 5 o'clock somewhere. Can I have some?
Yeah, can I get a little sippy sip?
Tell us about the event that you have coming up here.
Yeah, next Tuesday, I believe.
It's Tuesday night. So why don't you pour? I'm gonna get some sushi going. So you pour for the man, and I'm gonna get.
Tell us about the event because you're gonna teach us how to pair.
Exactly.
There's a science and art to it, correct?
Exactly. So everything has different flavors. This is actually a tokubetsu, which means it's a special sake. It's a different type of yeast used to make this sake, which the Toji head brewmaster decides. So this has a strong aromatic mushroom.
This is mushroom. So what flavor would you pair with?
Mushroom is earthy.
Now, would you pair something like this sushi with?
Well, I really don't recommend pairing rice with rice.
Really?
So I like to pair it with different types of veggies and beef and sashimi and other types of dishes. It's just kind of overpowering. The octopus would be great with the Wandering Poet. It's a little bit drier sake, so it's not going to overpower the flavor of the octopus. No, this is the okunumatsu.
So what goes well
with the
this
is going to pair great with the beef.
So you try
that one. And then try a piece of the beef.
All right, I get a piece of the beef.
You're gonna be nap time after this.
How often does Chuck get to be fed by a pretty lady?
I know, right? Not very often. Occasionally, though.
You get that mushroomness.
It does have that mushroom flavor. It's delicious. Right. So should I drink first and then eat, or either way, right?
Whatever your style.
Ends up in the same spot. Bon appetit. It's very good.
Yeah, absolutely. This next one is actually a nigori sake. So some of the proteins and fats are left in it, which is the rice sediment. I've already shooken it up, otherwise it would be set down at the bottom.
Now, are sake sparkling, or are they more like a liqueur, like a flat?
They are definitely flat. They do make sparkling sake. I don't recommend it because it's only 11% alcohol.
Okay.
So, you know.
Only 11%. Now, you do have, again, this event coming up where if you want to be a sake master, you've got, it's a $25 fee, but it's like a five-course meal, which is an incredible deal for anyone who's ever been to Piranha Killer Sushi, because you guys have an extensive menu.
Of course, Alamo Heights is all about wine. Everybody knows it. But we have customers coming in and want to branch out into sake, but they just don't know what to get. So we're going to start doing this actually every single first Tuesday of the month. If it goes well, of course, we'll do it every week or so on. But to inform customers about sake and different ways to pair it.
And this one goes with the octopus, you said, correct?
This one's a little bit sweeter. This is the Dreamy Clouds. Mm-hmm. So I would pair this with something that's spicy, once again, the beef or the crudo of Hamachi, as it has chili oil. Correct?
Hey, Paul, come on
really,
in
really
and
hot?
Sample this.
No,
I'm
not at all. Okay. It's not
I'm
too spicy.
I'm
going to
give you this one, and you can this one try this here. With the sashimi. Right?
And okay. This is a fish. And
or the sashimi? Strawberries with the
shallots.
For those that are chopstick challenged.
I got a fork right here.
Yeah. Okay.
I'll go ahead. Come on, man.
Come on,
Rome.
I can do it.
When in Rome, try the chopsticks.
Use your hands.
And again, they have both chopsticks and forks at Prawn & Killer Sushi.
You eat the fish.
Tuna. Yeah.
Try the tuna.
And then chase it with the.
Oh, that was my
voice. I told you. 3 second rule.
I gave you a warning.
Paul, this is good tuna.
He stabs it.
That was my foot Paul dropped it on.
That's actually pretty good.
Yeah.
Very good.
Kevin, how's business been at.
Oh, it's wonderful. We just completed our first year of business. The city's been great to us, especially the whole 09 crowd.
Sake mm-hmm. tasting next Tuesday, the 9th, Prawn & Killer Sushi from 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. For more information, at 822-1088. Wow. And again, this is going to be a monthly event, but it's going to be a lot of fun. You can try it. Again, how's the sake, gentlemen?
This is awesome.
Thank you.
Very good. Thank you.
Gentlemen,
you
say it's a success. Another huge event that we have coming up is going to be geared towards improving your health and getting you into shape. Details coming up.
All right.
Good stuff?
That's good. Yeah, it's good. Yeah, we all made this.
It's time for your Friday dose of the Daily Dish. Chuck.
Oh, you know, it's hard to believe it's been 4 years, almost four years, since Michael Jackson passed away. And we're still talking about that brother. Moment
that
of silence
is hard.
For Michael.
That is hard to believe,
yes.
Actually.
But this is about his daughter, Paris Jackson. She just turned 15 on Wednesday. And most people may not know that Debbie Rowe, the mother of Michael's children, signed away all of her parental rights.
Wow.
Yes. Yeah. So she had the kids, but they are Michael's children. And they have been estranged. They've not seen each other in 14 years. They had a reunion. They're reunited. And it feels so good, I'm sure. I mean, that's great. You know,
well, they had a lot to talk about.
I'm sure they did in 15 years there. But
they
tried
so
to,
much.
Yeah, they tried to keep it very, very private because obviously they want the kids to have a private life and as much of a normal upbringing as possible. But they got back together, the mom and the daughter right there, and they talked. So.
And they do look very similar.
Those eyes.
Okay. Those eyes.
Now, this next story, we all know about this gentleman. Kevin Ware, of course, he was with the University of Louisville. Yes. He's the guard that got hurt and broke his leg. It was really awful to see. Well, he's been showing up everywhere. He was on David Letterman, and of all things, guess what he did?
A top 10 list,
and it was really interesting. The 10th one was, what is that loud cracking sound?
That's not even funny.
Okay. And then he goes, I hope this doesn't leave a bruise.
All right.
And he goes, hey, look, it's my tibia. And, you know, it's amazing that he could do all that, but here's the top three.
Okay.
Number three.
They fire Leno.
Number two.
Heat then ice or ice then heat.
Yeah, we don't know. Nobody knows. And the number one thought going through Kevin Ware's mind at the moment of the broken leg.
At least my bracket's not busted.
That's right.
Yeah, he's a good sport doing that.
I could be crying.
That was brutal.
Been up on crutches since like the day after the surgery. I read one medical report that said, you know, especially with a compound fracture like that, you're supposed to be up on crutches as soon as possible. So
that's a man. Wow, there. That's a beast.
Awful. This next story made me really sad.
It's horrible. A legend, an icon, Roger Ebert. He was a renowned film critic. Passed away yesterday at the age of 70. I remember seeing him as a child watching Siskel and Ebert, thumbs up, thumbs down.
Yeah, they kind of coined that phrase.
After battling health problems and cancers for the last decade, he finally passed away yesterday at the age of 70. So, Roger, this is for you. We'll see you at the movies. Welcome back. Are you in the market for a new house or maybe just looking for some new ideas to spruce up your current digs? Well, we have just a place for you to get all of your inspiration. Here with us now is Leah Robinson, a marketing manager, and James Smothers, who's a sales counselor there with Civitas Homes. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Nice
to meet you. In the past, when we have done the tour of homes, we have seen just some amazing developments. Talk to me about where this new development's located.
It's actually Talise de Culebra. Uh-huh. It's actually the Spring Tour of Homes. It's this weekend and next weekend. Uh-huh. Free to the public. It's the ultimate open house.
Yeah.
If you get your San Antonio Express News, the tabloid, the Spring Tour tabloid is in it. It tells all the communities that are involved. We have 6 involved. Talise is one of our key communities. Actually, within that community, we're building a charity home for Leukemia Lymphoma Society. It's brought by, Greater Builders Association, and CPS Energy is, producing this. But this charity home is really great. We've had so many donors that are helping contribute to this charity home for leukemia. The Greater San Antonio Builders Association is also having a function next Saturday, mm-hmm. Kind of a material sale to help benefit. So he's going to.
Yeah. What I've seen though in these homes is people are able to go and just really get some great ideas. I mean, they go and you go, maybe I can't afford a new home just yet, but I can really get some ideas for how to spruce up my current home. And that's what you see when people are walking through, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. They get ideas as far as decorating. And then not only that, one of the things that we're going to be doing is going to be our big kickoff, which is going to be at Talise de Culebra, which is off of 1604 in Culebra. It's our flagship community for Civic Homes, and this Saturday from 11 to 4, we're going to have a hot dog cook-off. We're going to have KTSA is going to do a live remote out there, mm-hmm. and we're going to be talking about purchasing a new home here in San Antonio, how to qualify, the mortgage industry of it.
Great information for a lot of people.
Absolutely. How to fix credit, different things like that, and everything that it takes to actually purchase a new home. It's going to be information about new homes here in San Antonio and just the general real estate market here in San Antonio.
And a lot of these times, people, when they'll walk in, because we've done these tours of homes in the past, and a lot of times people go, wow, I can't afford a home in the million-dollar range. Sometimes we've seen them in the Dominion, but what are the price points that people are looking at for this particular spring tour of homes?
It could range from 120s to over a million between all the builders.
So
they are affordable. They are in all different price ranges and different designs. And
absolutely.
Yes. What are some of the design styles that people can expect to see in this particular tour of homes?
They'll see anywhere from different custom designs, from stucco to brick to stone. In Talise de Culebra, which is our flagship community, we're going to have 3 different series of homes that we're building there, all the way from the 170s to almost $500,000. Inside these homes, they're going to have a lot of included features, anywhere from 18 by 18 tile to granite countertops, 42-inch cabinets with crown molding, 3-side stone, a lot of included features already at the base price with Civic Homes.
And I think that's what a lot of people are really looking for, is being able to get some of those nice upgrades without feeling like they're cheating themselves of their brand new home, and being able to really get a nice brand new home with a little bit of a custom build. And if you haven't yet gotten your copy of the paper yet, here's what you want to look for when you go ahead and get that, is the Spring Tour of Homes. And this will give you, it has a kind of a mapped out a look of, when you go in there, the different communities. You said there's 6 different communities, correct?
We have 6 different communities, but actually if you go in there, there's a map and everything is by quadrant. So, northeast, northwest, so you can pick the area you choose to want to live in, or what you're interested in, and it'll tell you all those communities there and all the different builders and directions on how to get there. So it's a real good resource.
Yeah. And again, it is free and open to the public, and the great thing is if you visit 6 different homes, you can also get a $250 gas card.
Awesome. So go and visit all 6 homes, or visit 6 homes at least.
Perfect. And again, it's happening this weekend and next weekend. The Cibolo Canyons, you've got Copper Ridge, you've got Crystal Bella, you've got Huntington, and you've got Kinder Ranch. For more information, you can log on to kens5.com for all the different information. Thank you guys so much
for being here.
Yes. And I look forward to going out because I love getting design ideas, especially with spring around the corner and sprucing up the landscape.
That's awesome. We'd love to see you there.
Perfect. Thank you so much. Okay, coming up, how students can get a $200 gift card just for filling out their financial aid forms. Good stuff. Welcome back. They're one of the top real estate companies in the nation, but they have not forgotten the importance of community. Here to talk about some big plans they have for the Alamo City are Alfredo Lopez. He's the regional vice president of the Lind Company. And with you today are 2 of our coolest talent players. We've got Robert Quiroga. You are a local boy. And we've also got Burl Tolar. You're both wide receivers. Thank you guys so much for being here. First, I'm going to talk with you, Alfredo. You guys are so important to our community. If many people don't know this or not, your Lind properties, you guys are where our Mi Casa families stay while their houses are being renovated through our GDSA Mi Casa program. Talk to me about that.
Yes, thank you, Natalie. Really, it's a partnership that we've started probably well over about 5 years ago.
Yeah.
And it's one of the things that over the years we've been really excited to help the community out. Obviously, we're in the business of building communities and mm-hmm. getting out there with everybody. And when we learned about the program that you guys had going, it was something that we just jumped all over. And anything we could do to help out, we're always there.
And probably people don't even think about that you know, when people's homes are being renovated, they don't even think, oh, a family has to stay somewhere. And why not with you guys? You have several different properties all throughout the city.
Yes, as a matter of fact, here in San Antonio, we have over 24 communities. That's roughly about 5,000 individual apartment homes when you think about it, how many families we actually touch.
Uh-huh.
And nationwide, we have about 130 properties. So it's something that we're really excited about.
And of course, you know, a lot of you guys help out a lot of the talents players and some of the other sporting teams and stuff like that.
That's correct. You know, the spring season, like anything in San Antonio, gets real busy. And for the Lenny Company, it's very exciting because we have arena football that we're now involved in.
Mm-hmm.
It's now our second year, and we had a very successful first year with us winning the conference. And you know, for us as a Lynn Company, we're also a big supporter of the community and all the teams, the Talons. We do stuff with the Silver Stars, stuff with the San Antonio Scorpions. And it's really a way to bring entertainment to San Antonio, and, you know, hopefully we can be a part of that.
Now, we'll talk with the Talons in just a second because I know, you know, they're a huge part, and we love our arena football, but you guys have, you're a real big help with also the Brighton Center. You guys have a big event for the Brighton Center.
Very good. Actually, with Fiesta coming up right now, for those individuals that have been out to the Taste of the North Side, it's really been a huge event that's grown over the years. It's in its 14th year, and I remember several years ago it started as a small event with maybe about 500 people. It's actually generating about 7,000 individuals that are going out there, and that's at the club at Sonterra. And that's usually the Wednesday, I believe it's the 24th of the Fiesta Week. And the Lenny Company is obviously the proud sponsor and presenter of
and
that
that's
event.
That's such a huge event for children with disabilities and families of children with disabilities because it just helps them out in so many different ways and provides just that support system that they need.
Exactly.
And let's talk with our talented players. Now, Robert, I'm going to talk with you first because you're a local boy. You went to Holmes High School.
That's right, yeah.
So how does it feel to be playing for a professional team back here in your hometown?
It was truly an honor, you know, to be able to finally have a team here in San Antonio so that I can come back and play. I mean, I'm going into now, this is my seventh year playing arena.
Mm-hmm.
So now being able to come home, play in San Antonio in front of family and friends gave me a great opportunity to be back home with the people that I, you know, admire and show my support for the community that supported me throughout the years.
Now, bro, you're from California, but you're now here in San Antonio. What's it like to play in front of a, you know, such a spirited city like San Antonio? We love our athletes. We love our sports.
I love it. I love it out here. Coming from California, similar to Robert, mm-hmm. this is my eighth year playing professionally. And San Antonio, there's nothing like it. I mean, we have great fans, great support. I felt welcome right when I came here last year, so looking forward to a great season this year.
Now you guys have a big game tonight against Chicago. The second game of the season is tonight. Mm-hmm. How do you guys feel? You guys feel you're going to do okay? You feel you're going to be victorious?
We're coming off of a bye week, so we're all feeling good. And tonight, 7:30, hope to see you guys there.
All right, now you guys have a special deal for Great Day SA viewers, don't you?
Yes, we do. As a matter of fact, it's an entertainment package, and because we're involved with all of the teams here in the community, for the individuals that are leasing an apartment over the next couple of weeks, you get the opportunity, if you lease with us, you're going to get two tickets to the Taste of the North Side, two tickets to the Talons game, two tickets also to a Silver Stars game and the Scorpions game once their season begins. So we're really excited about that, and we encourage everybody to go to our website, lynnliving.com,
to learn more about that. Now that's what I call a weekend date extravaganza.
That it
doesn't get much better than that. Check out the information on your screen. Send that promo code GDSA to LindSA at LindWorld.com. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Guys.
All right, thanks for being with us today. We had a lot of fun. We have our dinosaur winner. That's Anika McGarity, 11 years old.
Yay!
Thank you. And we want to thank her parents, Turner and
picture.
Jolene McGarity, for submitting the entry. So congrats, Anika. That is a cute picture. What does it say on that picture?
It says, ooh, and I've had one too many blades of grass.
That's a triceratops. We also want to say thank you to the Airheads behind me here. Remember the Fight for Air 5K run and walk for the American Lung Association tomorrow at 8 a.m. at SeaWorld.
Be
for
there.
More information, visit fightforairwalk.org. Thanks for coming today, guys.
Okay. Hey, you know what? Now it's time for a party, a sake party.
Sake!
Have a good Friday!
Looks like they're already partying over here. All right.
Oh, awesome. Look at this one.
Oh, okay. Easy check, easy.
Okay, easy. That's right. I'm going to go back to work after
I'll take
this.
The T-Rex.
Excuse me, sir. Do you have any more?
Chopsticks.
No more chopsticks.
cast a spell on me, you hit me like the sky fell on me, and I decided you look well on me, so let's go somewhere no one else can see you and me. Turn the lights out now, now I'll take you by the hand, hand you another drink, drink it in.